The other day I thought you said you slept slow. Yes, I knew that laughter, okay. Now I see. You wouldn't even know him if it hadn't been for me. Sometimes in the fading light, I can't help thinking back to, well, the way we were. And then I start feeling guilty lying next to her. I know, but it can't be right. Pretending that it's you, you still won't go away. Pretending that it's you, you still won't go away. You're right again, perhaps you weren't sending him. It's just that I don't really want your answers to appear. Oh no, I just think she might forget I ever said that I'd just be scared. I told her all about you and I don't think she even cared. I know, but it's not alright. Pretending that it's you, you still won't go away. Pretending that it's you, you still won't go away.
don't know. I think as a, speaking as a British person, you kind of feel more British when you're in America because you appreciate what makes you British and because it makes you different from everybody else really, and you do start to miss British culture. Then when I go back home, things that I thought I missed, I don't care about. I think, why did I miss that? It was great living in Seattle or Los Angeles. So I haven't decided really. Is the sitting on the fence answer? I don't know. I'm not sure what I am really anymore. I think we're from a caravan in Birmingham, Alabama, aren't we at the moment? I mean literally. I had a flat in LA, but there's no point having it, carrying on renting it because we're on tour now till Christmas. So I'm kind of homeless, and the bass player lives in LA, and the guitarist and the drummer are actually both from Scotland, so we're kind of from nowhere, really.
That was one particular
afraid. That you are just seeing me as a chance of getting laid.
On the fourth Cinerama LP, which we were doing in Seattle, and as we were arranging the songs and stuff, it just seemed kind of sound more and more like The Wedding Present, really, and less like Cinerama. And actually, we were doing a session for John Peel, funnily enough, and as you say, I've done loads of sessions for that program, and it was a Cinerama session. But the engineers and the producers were saying, David, this is The Wedding Present. You know, you come in here, you call it Cinerama. You know, there's no strings, there's no, because with Cinerama it's a lot more orchestrated. There was keyboards and it was a kind of a lot more pop, really. It was a weird decision, because it was a non-decision in a way. It kind of crept up on us, and we just thought, it's The Wedding Present. Let's just call it The Wedding Present. So everyone agreed, and we just did it.
This is called You Turn Me On. I saw you staring. Pretended not to care. You left your hirsute presence hanging in the air. I didn't want to fall in love, but now I think you changed my mind. Yeah, there was someone, but that was years ago. She was positively charming, but I had to let her go. She needed to be adored, and I just didn't. No way since then that I ever wanted anyone to stay again. But you just really turned me on. And I can't take my eyes off you tonight. And if you ask me to make love to you, I might. 'Cause nobody's ever made me feel like this before. It's disconcerting, it's becoming quite surreal. There is no point in asking, 'cause I don't know how I feel. I'm just sure that this is something to do. There's no way since then. Stay again. You just really tell me.
And people say, you know, well, you must have felt, I felt very fortunate that, that Peel, you know, liked the band. And obviously I do, but at the same time, he was so hugely influential to me. It's kind of obvious that he would, because it, I was just kind of absorbing what he was, had been playing me for the previous, like, 20 years or whatever, 10 years or whatever, and then kind of regurgitating it in a way. So it was almost as if it would have been disappointing had he not been a fan of The Wedding Present, really, because it would have been, it would have been weird, you know, because we were, you know, such a John Peel-type band. And obviously it was a great honour to be associated with him, to do sessions for the programme. You know, to this day, you know, some of my proudest moments were actually, you know, recording sessions for that programme. You know, people say, oh, yeah, it must be great to play in Japan and to go on Top of the Pops and all those kinds of stuff. And it was great, but, you know, again, it was such a driving force, you know, the idea of being on John Peel's programme, that, you know, those other things are kind of less important, really.
And there's one more thing that's come inside. Now I'm all alone. Danny isn't here today. She said she had to get away. It's on your right. It's by the telephone. She promised not to try and ring. So far I haven't heard a thing. Something I must know. You shook your head when you walked away. I think you maybe had a row. I know you wouldn't leave him now. The things you said as you turned my way. The look that came into your eyes, it kind of told me by surprise. You can't have not known. I'll be here on my own. Stay. Once ago, yes, all right, I stay. You're just as bad as me, and I know where I'd rather be. When we kiss, one day soon we'll laugh at this. Just tonight we've got everything. So stop listening for the door. I told you where she went before. Nothing can go wrong if you're not here too long. Stay all night, I bet. Look who is coming up. I can't believe you want to go. We'll be right back. It's late. The waiter's stacking the chairs, but nevertheless, just wait. I don't think he really cares. And if we leave now, I'll be kicking myself all week. Cause we get so few chances to talk just like this. And I would regret just saying see you, cause this is something that I really miss. So I aim to detain you for as long as I dare. You just don't care. To the brim, and though I despise listening to you talk about him, seeing you being with that man is much better than not seeing you at all. You can't leave, not when we've been having such a ball. Just don't understand. To you, boo-boo, tonight. Thank you.
Thank you very much indeed. See you again. Good night.